Hello everyone, I'm Sushmita Sarkar from RV College of Engineering. Welcome all of you for the course Power System Analysis 2. This is lecture 8 in module 1. So here we are mainly going to study about the Gauss-Seidel method. So before this, we have studied the network model formulation and the formation of wide bus by inspection and singular transformation method. And only after understanding the formation wide bus, we can understand the load flow problem. So we have understood in the last lectures also what are the basic load flow concepts, what are the parameters, what are the buses, and what is static load flow equations and why that equation is nonlinear in nature. And why do we go for iterative techniques to do load flow analysis? So one of the methods which we have discussed in the last class is Gauss-Seidel method. So let us understand what do we have in this particular method. Fine. So I have told you that usually I will first make you understand what is Gauss method, or which we call it as a Gauss elimination method, and how does Gauss-Seidel method is different from Gauss elimination method. So to understand that, let us see what does Gauss-Seidel method is all about. Fine. So Gauss-Seidel method is popular iterative algorithm for solving nonlinear algebraic equations. So in this, initial vectors will be usually assumed. Fine, and at every subsequent iteration, the solution is updated till the convergence is reached. So you will be understanding these 2-3 lines in the algorithm much more better way. Fine. So here we assume, if you are assuming your system consisting of only PQ buses, if you remember, we have discussed in our last class that we have basically two types of buses, PV and PQ buses, and another type of bus which comes due to the necessity, that which we call it as a slack bus. Fine. So if you consider a network which consists only of PQ buses, obviously slack bus is a must. Fine. So in that case, you will have n minus of one complex voltage equations. Why? Because slack bus is already magnitude of voltage and angle is known. So you need not to calculate voltage for that particular bus. Hence, for all the other buses which we are stating as a PQ buses, you need to calculate the complex bus voltages. So that's why we have written over here, you need to calculate n minus one complex voltages. Fine, for ease of programming, slack bus is generally numbered as 1. Then we number it, the next number usually goes to the PV bus, and then we number it the PQ buses. That is just for ease of programming purpose. Fine. So we have already seen the static load flow equation yesterday. In the last class. So in that we have seen that YP is equal to 1 by YPP, PP minus of JQP, VP conjugate, minus sigma Q is equal to 1 to N, but not equal to P, YPQ, VQ. Fine. So in this, we have in Gauss elimination method, if you want to find out the voltage at a particular bus, in that case, we have to take the initial value of every last iteration. So all of you remember that PQ bus, the known values are the real power and the reactive power. What you are supposed to find out? The magnitude of the voltage and delta. To know that value only, we are using the static load flow equation. I hope I'm clear with this concept. Fine. So in this particular equations, we have to go for, see now here we are going to use the equation for the rest of the buses. And you know, this equation is nonlinear, and that's how we go for iterative technique. Okay. So consider a 4-bus system with bus 1 as a slack bus. So how do I, if I have a 4-bus system, and if I'm writing bus voltage, first bus is a slack bus, and you want to know the second PQ bus voltage, so you have to substitute the values like this, open the sigma. So yes, last class also we have seen that how it is being substituted, where Q is equal to 1 but not equal to P. So when you substitute in this particular format, so what will happen, you know the value. Please remember, since you have taken the bus 1 as a slack bus, so in that case there is no question of giving an iteration count for the V1, because V1 slack bus is fixed, it's specified, so you cannot change that voltage. Fine. So this is fixed, so never put an iteration count for the bus which is you have considered as slack bus. Fine, so now the other buses V3 of 0, V4 of 0. Now what is this V3 of 0, V4 of 0? So remember, you're in this four bus, first bus number 1 is a slack bus, 2, 3 and 4 are PQ buses. Fine, so here the initial voltages at all these buses will be assumed. And you know your assumption should be always near to your actual value. So usually we assume these voltages at 1 plus of J0. Which we call it as a flat voltage profile. I repeat, all the initial value of PQ buses voltages will be considered as 1 plus J0, which we tell as flat voltage profile. Fine. So now you see this, how do we write? When I'm calculating a second bus voltage at the first iteration, I'll be considering the third voltage and the fourth voltage as the initial value, which is 1 plus of J0. Now, where do I get the value of Y21, Y23, Y24? Because that's the reason we have learned first formation of Y bus. Because if I don't know how to form an Y bus, what are the elements of Y bus, I cannot substitute the value in static load flow equation. Fine. So exactly, you will be getting the value of Y bus from the method of inspection or method of singular transformation, doesn't matter, because you know in both the methods you get the same answer. Your output result is same. Fine. So here you get it as so you'll be getting these values from your Y bus. V1 is already specified. The voltage will be specified for slack bus. V3, V4 is 1 plus J0. Coming back to this, V2 also you'll be initializing as 1 plus J0 because the second bus is also a PQ bus. So here we are mainly talking about considering only PQ buses. Fine. So P2 and Q2. The question with P2 and Q2, the P2 is a total real power at the bus 2, which is usually generated minus load. So P2 we write it as PG minus of PL. Q2 we write it as QG minus of QL. Fine. There are many buses where you may have a generator and you also have a load at the same bus. So in that case, real power will be the generated power minus the load power will give you the resultant power. That is your P2, net power in that particular bus. In the same fashion, you will be writing the Q2 also. So please remember this particular point. Okay. So when we do the problem, we'll see this. Fine. So this is your iteration number 1. We are writing the voltage. Similarly, for iteration number 2, what I'm going to do it here now in the previous bus voltage, which we have already has put it as V2 of 1, we got the value. So in my V3 of 1 equation, my V2 of 1 will be updated value. Fine. The last value, that is V2 of 1. So in V2 of 1, I have not yet calculated V3 of 1 and I have not calculated V4 of 1. So I was taking the previous values, whatever available with us. But when you go for the next bus voltage, this voltage is already calculated. Okay, this voltage is already calculated. So that's why in your equation, what do we get it as? We get it as V2 of 1 and V4 of 0, because V4 of 1 is yet to calculate. After V3 of 1, only V4 of 1 will come. Fine. So that's how you get it as V4 of 0. So next you calculate V4 of 1. So when you calculate for V4 of 1, V2 of 1 and V3 of 1 is already calculated. So what you do in Gauss-Seidel is you are immediately updated values we are using in the next equation. This is what is Gauss-Seidel technique. So what is Gauss elimination method is, or what is Gauss method is, suppose you are solving for the first iteration. So for first iteration, for all the bus voltages, we are using all the previous bus voltages. For an example, suppose this is your Gauss method. So in Gauss method, V3 of 0, which we have written over here, so V3 of 1 will become over here, V2 of 0 and V4 of 0. If it is a Gauss method or Gauss elimination method, then you will not use the value V2 of 1. You would have used the value V2 of 0, V4 of 0. Similarly, over here also, V2 of 0 and V3 of 0. That means if you are in the first iteration, all the bus voltages which you are using in your expression will be the value of last iteration. So if you go for the second iteration, then all these values will be 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. If you are going for the second iteration, with this, what will happen? The convergence will take longer time. Fine. So it will, you have to, your calculation time increases because you are using the last iteration values for your current iteration. But in Gauss Seidel, what we are doing, we are making the convergence faster by immediately updated values using in the very next equation. So I hope I'm clear with this particular concept. Fine. I repeat, Gauss elimination, you will be using all the values of the previous iteration. For an example, V3 of 1, I will be writing V2 of 0 and V4 of 0. Fine. You will not be using the updated. When you start using the updated value, which you have calculated just now, then this makes you a Gauss Seidel method. But if you use the complete voltages from the last iteration, then this becomes Gauss elimination method. Fine. I hope this is clear to all of you. Let us go to the next slide. Fine. So in next slide, we see is, hence, at the iteration of 1, after the first iteration, what do you do? You do the voltages at all the buses are obtained. Fine. So at the end, you, if you have n number of PQ buses, you have found all the PQ buses voltages. Now, what should I do next? I'm going to find out the difference between the last two iteration values. Fine. So this is your bus 2. So I'm going to find out delta V2 of 1. First iteration is over. Now I'm going to find out the change in the voltage. Okay, so that will be V2 of 1 minus V2 of 0. Fine, similarly, you'll be finding off V3 and V4. Now in this, whichever is the maximum value, okay, out of V2 of 1, V3 of 1, V4 of 1, whichever is the max of these three, fine, that should be less than or equal to tolerance. Tolerance is something defined which says the convergence is reached. Okay, so now this tolerance will be either given in the form of 0.1, 0.001, 0.01, depends on the system requirement. Fine. So in that case, if you reach to this particular tolerance value, then we say that system is converged, and this tolerance value should be checked at the end of every iteration. Fine. Similarly, if I go for the second iteration, then this will become V2 of 2 and V2 of 1. Fine. The last two iterations take the difference, find out all the buses and take the maximum among all the delta V's and check whether it is a less than or equal to the tolerance value. Fine. So let us see that. I think we'll be going for the next iteration. So second iteration. So again, you're writing V2 of 2. So in Gauss Seidel method, if you're writing V2 of 2, so here it will be V2 1. Conjugate, because V2 of 2 you cannot write over here, because V2 of 2 you are calculating right now. Fine. So it has to be V2 of 1. Last iteration value you have to write down. Similarly, V1 you cannot put any value because it is a slack bus. So there's no iteration count should be written on top. V3 of 1 I have updated. Fine. And V4 of 1 is updated from last iteration. V3 of 2 and V4 of 2 is yet to be calculated next. Fine. So this is your equation for the second bus in second iteration. Similarly, you will be doing for the V3 of 2. So when you do V3 of 2, V2 of 2 is already calculated. So immediately this updated voltage have to be substituted over here. Okay. So this gives you V2 of 2. V4 of 2 is not yet calculated. So I'll be using V4 of 1. Okay. So I hope it is clear to you. How do we write the static load flow equation for Gauss Seidel? If this would have been Gauss elimination, then these all voltages we would have written 1, 1, 1. There's no question because I am doing a second iteration. So all the values will be a first iteration. Okay. Similarly, V4 of 2. So here V2 of 2 is also updated. V3 of 2 also updated. Immediately I'm substituting that in V4 of 2 calculation. Fine. So this is all gives you an idea about how do you do the voltage, how to find out the voltage and their angles with the help of static load flow equation. Fine. So after this, what is the next step? Yes, we are going to find out the delta V. Again, find out the delta V and find out the delta V max. Fine. So now delta of V2 of 2 will be V2 of 2 minus V2 of 1. Similarly, delta V3 and V4 of 2. So in this, you find out what is your maximum value. and then you check with your whether delta V max is less than or equal to epsilon. Fine. So in general, SLFE for Gauss-Seidel can be written as, so I'm writing a generalized equation. So remember this generalized equation. So what I'm writing, I'm calculating for a bus VP of K, 1 by YPP, PP minus of JQP. You remember the same, you cannot write over your K because for VP of K, you're calculating. So you can, you don't know what is the value of it. So you take the value of previous iteration, which is VP K minus 1 conjugate minus. Fine. Now, how do I write this sigma sign? It's very simple to remember because you know, you take the updated values. Okay. You take the immediate updated values will be of the same iteration, your kth iteration, and which you need to update it will be your k minus one iteration. Fine. So right now I'm calculating for k iteration. So up to which value I'll be knowing? So I will start q is equal to one. Okay. Q is equal to 1 to what value? Up to what value will be knowing the voltages? That is the previous voltage of this. So previous bus voltage of this will be P minus 1. Okay. The previous bus voltage, you will be knowing it. So you will be putting, substituting their value of the immediate iteration values. Fine. So I know the updated values of VP minus 1. So that's why your Q is equal to P minus 1. YPQ, VQ of the same iteration value will be putting as K. Fine. And after this values, after P plus one, this is your P calculator, VP calculating. After VP plus one, I need yet to calculate. So those values I will be taking from previous iteration. So what do you write? Q is equal to, till P minus one, you know the value, updated value, so it is iteration K. P, you are already determining. So P plus one will be, you are yet to calculate. So you will be using a previous iteration voltages. So it will be Q is equal to P plus 1 to N, YPQ, VQ, K minus 1. Okay. So I hope this particular equation, static load flow equation for a Gauss-Seidel method is understood by all of you. Fine. If I tell you to write the same equation for Gauss method or Gauss elimination method, how does my equation changes? Fine. You know, in Gauss method, my all the voltages will be previous iteration. So what will happen? My this particular term will go up. I will be simply writing Q is equal to 1 to N, not equal to P, YPQ, VQ, K minus 1. Okay, I repeat, in Gauss simulation, what will happen? This will term, this first term, this will remain as it is. When you write the second term, this second term in Gauss simulation, what will happen? It will happen Q is equal to N, YPQ, VQ, K minus 1. Remember, Q is equal to 1 to N, but not equal to P, YPQ, VQ, K minus 1, because you use all the voltages of the last iteration. Fine. I hope it's clear. So next, let us see algorithm for Gauss-Seidel method. So this particular algorithm only by considering the PQ buses. Fine. Still, I have not introduced the concept of PV bus. We are just now learning only about PQ buses, because if you understand the flow of the algorithm by using PQ buses, then it will be very easy for us to understand even with a PV bus. Fine. So what do we do? What is the first step when we go for a load flow by using a Gauss-Seidel method? First step is read the bus data and the line data, because only when you read the bus data and line data, bus data will help you to understand what are the different type of buses you have in your system. Line data will help you to understand the impedance value of those lines, which you need to convert into admittance and will give you a Y bus. So basically, line data will help me in forming the Y bus, and bus data will help me to give me the data of different buses. Fine. Next is what? Step two. So next step two is what? You have to form a Y bus by using your line data. Fine. Very soon after that, we are including the step two itself, that you should consider all the PQ bus voltages as a flat voltage profile, which we say 1 plus of J0. Fine. That's the first thing. Second thing, set your convergence criteria, which we put it as epsilon. This convergence criteria, you have to assume whether you want to take, whether you want the error to be 0.1, 0.001 or 0.01, depends, fine. So set that criteria. Number three is set iteration count K is equal to one. So start your iteration. So you know, in your first iteration, in your one iteration, you have to take care of all the buses. So set iteration count, and after that will come set bus count. Fine. So you have to take care of all the buses. You have to calculate V2 of one, V3 of one, V4 of one, and then only you will check whether your delta Vmax has reached or not. If it is not reached, then only you go for next iteration. Is it okay? So if my convergence has not reached, then I will go for K is equal to K plus one in the next iteration. That is the flow. Fine. So what we do is, so we check for slack bus. Whether my bus, first bus is a slack bus or not, you're checking. If it is not a slack bus, go to next step. Since voltage at slack bus is fixed both in magnitude and phase, and it does not vary during iterative procedure, go to step number 7 if it is a slack bus. So if it is a slack bus, we'll go to step number 7. We'll see in step number 7 what do we have. But if it is not a slack bus, then go to step number 6. So basically in step number 6, you have to calculate your static load flow equation. Okay. You have to find out your bus voltages by using SLFE. So now what is this? We know, we just now we saw the generalized equation of SLFE. So by using this, we'll do that. And then you find out the absolute difference between the last two iteration values. So basically you will be calculating delta V of K and Vp of K minus, which is your Vp K minus one, we saw just now. Fine, so here what happens? So here your step number 7 says, advance the bus count by 1 to evaluate other values of Vp of K and delta Vp of K. Fine, so you are going to check the, you are going to do for one bus is over, go for the second bus, go for the third bus, with every bus calculate their delta Vs. Fine, once you calculate the voltage and delta V for all the buses, then you check for the whether you have covered all the buses or not. So check if all the buses you have taken into account. If yes, go to next step, else go to step number 5. Okay, so what is my next step is, determine the largest absolute value of change in voltage delta V max. Okay, so I'm going to find out which is the largest V max. Fine, so if your this delta V max is less than or equal to epsilon, then the solution is converged and hence display the values of all voltages. Fine, if not, advance the iteration count K by 1 and go to step number 4. Very simple to understand. I hope all of you have understood the logic. Basically, what is my algorithm talk about? That is the first thing you read the line data and bus data. Line data will help you to form the Y bus. Once you form the Y bus, the bus data will help you to know the different type of buses you have. So you are going to check for the PQ buses. If the PQ buses, for the PQ buses, you need to assume the initial voltage profile, which is your 1 plus J0. We call it as a flat voltage profile. And also you have to assume your convergence criteria. Fine. After that, you start your iteration count. So after you start iteration count, then you start your bus count. Once your P becomes equal to 1, the first thing you check whether your first bus is a slack bus or not. If the first bus becomes slack bus, it was written you have to jump to step number 7. So if you look over here, your step number 7 says what? Advance the bus count. So you have to go to P equal to P plus 1 if P is a slack bus, first bus is a slack bus. Fine, if it is not, you use the voltage equation, static load flow equation, and for a Gauss-Seidel method, and find out the voltages at all the buses and their delta V's, respective delta Vp of K, we find out for that particular iteration. Then what we do is, we check for the delta V max, whether the delta V max is less than or equal to convergence or not. If it is yes, reach to a convergence, then your procedure stops there. After that, you find out the slack bus powers, line flows, line losses, we are going to find out. But if it is not satisfying the convergence criteria, then we go back and increase the iteration count K is equal to K plus 1 and repeat the procedure. So I hope the algorithm of GS method is only for PQ buses. It's clear to all of you. Fine. So with this, it's a quiz time. Okay. So let me see whether you have understood or not. What is the first question? Differentiate between Gauss and Gauss-Seidel method with the help of SLFE. Okay, so basically you have to write a static load flow equation for Gauss and Gauss-Seidel method. So we have discussed. So anybody will try to just give an attempt? Just now we have spoken about both the methods, how the SLFE looks in both the cases. Fine. Let us see. In Gauss elimination method or Gauss method, it is look like this. Vp of k is equal to 1 by ypp, pp minus of jqp, vpk minus 1 conjugate minus sigma q is equal to 1 to n not equal to p, ypq vq k minus 1. Okay, because all the voltages we will be taking of the last iteration, hence it is k minus 1 voltages. But for GS method, we get that particular term divided into two terms, where the first, the second term in this particular case indicates I'm going to use the updated values of the voltages just before this bus, and after this bus voltage, we are going to calculate the previous iteration values. So this is your general formula for GE and GS method. Fine. What is the next question? Question number two. Okay, answers come first. So what is the question? For a power system with four buses, write general SLFE for load flow at bus three for third iteration using Gauss-Seidel method. Same thing I put it, told you to write in a Gauss-Seidel method. So which gives you V3 of three is equal to 1 by Y33. So you are writing a bus number three. Total number of buses are what? Four. You are writing an equation for three. What is the iteration? Three. Fine. Iteration three, bus three, number of buses are four. So V3 of three is equal to 1 by Y33, P3 JQ of three, V3 of two, V3 of three, you don't know you're calculating. So it'll be V3 of two minus. Before this, I will be knowing the value. You know, the V1 will be usually by default, if it is not mentioned also, first bus will be taken as a slack bus. So I'm not rating any iteration count over here. V2 of three will be calculated before this. So V2 of three, but V4 of three is yet to be calculated. We'll be writing V4 of two. Okay. So I hope this is clear, the doubt of GS method, how to write an equation for any kind of system for any particular iteration given to you. I think hope all of you know how to write now SLFE for Gauss-Seidel method. Okay, so with this, I end my lecture today. I hope all of you have understood the concept of GS method. Next lecture, we'll do the problem, which is only for PQ buses. Thank you for listening. Have a nice day. Goodbye.